Hi students, welcome once again. Here we are going to discuss about the contributions of Kesari Balakrishna Pillai in Malayalam journalism. What was his relation? What was his contribution to Malayalam journalism? His concept of free press and how he stood for the free press or opinion free journalism. How he stood against the authorities, how people could influence his writing, what was the power of his pen, like that, all these things associated with his newspapers like Samadarshi, Prabodhagan and Kesari. And now move on to our class, Kesari A. Balakrishna Pillai and Malayalam journalism. As a journalist, Pillai was called as the Kerala Socrates. Have you heard about that? Kerala Socrates was Kesari Balakrishna Pillai. He was visionary. His vision was vivid and different in journalism too. Pillai first worked as an editor of Samadarshi. And later, he started his own journal, Prabodhagan. And by collecting funds from people inside and outside India. Prabodhagan was banned and he founded and published Kesari, an important weekly discussing politics and literature. Through the columns of Kesari, he fought against the autocracy of the Diwan of the princely states of Travancore. Kesari was also banned by the government because of its criticisms against the misdeeds of government. I am going back to the history of journalism and relation to Kesari Balakrishna Pillai. Samadarshi, which commenced publication from Thiruvananthapuram in 1918, was a powerful and popular vehicle of public opinion. Kesari Balakrishna Pillai joined this paper in 1922 as an editor. He reverted his attention on the corrupt and high-handed bureaucracy of Travancore. The devastating criticism in Samadarshi went down well with the reading public. But the authorities were displeased and the owner of the paper was faced with difficulties. It is said that the notorious Travancore Newspaper Regulation Act of 1926 were an offshoot of Balakrishna Pillai's incisive criticisms. The management of the paper was not prepared to invite official displeasure and Kesari Balakrishna Pillai has to resign in 1926. Samadarshi went on without having all these problems handled, but it lost its circulation and closed down in late 40s. In the series of infamous moves plotted by government of Travancore against the institution of a free press, the Newspaper Regulation Act of 1926 deserves special mention as much for its stringency as for the opposition is generated among the reading public. The regulation was made by Diwan Wat, and it was a situation where journalism was in a move of nationalistic thoughts and political consciousness was evoking, and the need for responsible government was also pointed by this journalism. It was high time, the press was gagged and muscled, so the things were going so strict and the regulation was draconian measure requiring newspaper to take out license and deposit a security as token of their bona fides. Criticism of any member of the royal family, Travancore royal family, the Travancore government or the British King Emperor would result in the cancellation of the security or the seizing of the security and the cancellation of the license. A fresh license would be issued at the discretion of the authorities but would require a further substantial sum as security. So again the newspaper owners has to submit a security, pay a security, and it would be a huge amount which is not tolerable by the poor newspaper owners. Or the financial condition of Travancore was such first that, and a second cancellation of the license would be fatal to the publication. Possession of copies of publications whose license were suspended was a punishable offense too. So people can't subscribe such publications. And A. Balakrishnapilla, who had earlier been eased out of editorial responsibility of the Samadarshi, had in the meanwhile launched a new periodical, his own periodical, Prabodhagan. Prabodhagan was launched in 1930, June 4. And it has to close by September 10. Such a short life. The periodical was banned by the government of Travancore. The same reason as Balakrishnapilla's way of writing, his criticism against the authorities. Balakrishnapilla now started the Kesari. Later he became famous in the annuals of Malayalam journalism. And so Kesari Balakrishnapilla closed this publication Prabodhagan by September 10. And by September 12, from a person, Kalikkal Veetil Narayanapilla from Perinad Kollam, he bought the publication rights of Kesari. 4 rupees, 25 rupees. And September 18 itself, he started publishing Kesari, the most prestigious newspaper. It make him known as Kesari Balakrishnapilla. Criticism against the authorities was taken up with the added seal in the columns of this new publication, Kesari. With their misdeeds exposed to the public gaze, the Diwan and his cohorts were put in a tight corner. Newspaper regulations of 1926 took shape against the backdrop, and public reaction was instantaneous. A huge public meeting was organized at Thiruvananthapuram. Legislators, editors, leaders participated in the protest meeting. Resolutions were passed denouncing new measures. The legislators decided to sponsor a resolution at the next meeting of the assembly opposing the regulations, and if necessary, reject the budget and tender their resignation. Like that, things were going in that sense. And never before had a governmental proclaim evoked with widespread determination or something like that. A delegation of journalists waited on the Regent Maharani to convey their protests, but they were directed to Diwan. Swaraj editor A.K. Pilla led the deputation to Diwan and gave them a patient hearing. But the Diwan could not give them any assurance about their apprehensions. The deputation came back disappointed. June 26, 1926, the day the newspaper regulation took effect, was observed as a day of mourning by the people of Trivandrum. The struggle was then carried on in the legislature. A legislator attempted to introduce a bill seeking withdrawal of the regulation. The Diwan refused permission to introduce the bill. A motion was then sponsored at the budget session demanding that the regulation be revoked. But a clever manipulation of the votes of officials and nominated representatives, the motion was thrown out. As a measure of individual protest, Barrister A.K. Pilla resigned from legislature. The authorities now felt that the tide of opposition had been effectively stemmed. Kesari Balakrishnapilla stood strong. Though the government had frustrated the spontaneous public thought or public move to withdraw the Newspaper Regulation Act, Kesari Balakrishnapilla did not concede defeat. His writing acquired a hitherto unknown sharpness and crusading effect. He sought to mobilize public opinion against the government and its repressive measures. Sensing that the situation would get out of their hands if such strong dissent was permitted, the authorities clamped a ban order on the Kesari. Kesari was short-lived. But its impact on public opinion and on the development of Malayalam journalism was tremendous and out of proportion to its longevity. To Kesari Balakrishna Pilla, the press was not only a vehicle to project news, it was also a forum for educating the public by disseminating knowledge and encouraging free thought and open discussions. In keeping with the view, Kesari gave equal importance to news and to novels, short stories, book reviews and science notes in his columns. In this respect, it marked a point of departure in Malayalam journalism. With the Kesari ban, Balakrishna Pilla bid goodbye to his chosen profession. A large number of newspapers in Kerala were published with the aim of changing social realities and customs. Some of them were focusing on social reforms, some others on political independence and freedom of the country. Many of these newspapers were started by community organizations or political formations. But several of them are started by individuals who are motivated by higher ideals and goals. And this was the case with Kesari Balakrishna Pilla. Thank you. Hope you got an idea about Kesari Balakrishna Pilla. See you with another subject in next class. Thank you.